Hi, I'm Kate, physiotherapist, and today I will tell you about NICU, the machines and devices that you can find in the world. Let's start with the fact that neonatal intensive care unit is a very stressful environment, not only for the patient, for the baby, but also for the parents and for the family. There are tons of machines, monitors, alarms, beeps, lots of stuff going refresh. And in all of this, there's your little tiny baby who can weigh less than a small bottle of water. Sometimes you can barely see it because it is wrapped with bandages, tubes and devices. It all looks very scary, very complicated, you are afraid to touch anything and you just feel overwhelmed. So I will tell you about these devices, what they look like and why we use them. As usual, you get the chapter markers in the timeline of the video, so if you want to know more about any particular device, you can just jump straight to the part you are interested in. Okay, so let's start with the biggest one. After delivery, your baby will be placed in a special bed called an incubator. This is a large machine encased with transparent plastic. It is used to provide your baby with the proper amount of heat, oxygen and humidity. Being in the womb, the baby is provided with the right conditions for development. When we prematurely pull the baby out, we simply need to provide it with as similar conditions as possible. That's what incubators are for. The machine can be connected to heart rate monitoring display. It has an oxygen sensor inside. Usually it has an X-ray tray. You may also see a panel that is used to control temperature and humidity. Below you can see a water tank and a lifting stand with wheels. The incubator has holes on each side through which you can put your hands inside. Throughout these holes, the medical staff performs all necessary procedures for your baby. Most likely through these holes, you'll be able to touch your baby for the first time. But be sure to discuss it with a doctor or nurse first. Other devices that you can encounter in the NICU are breath-helping machines. Sometimes lungs of a premature baby are not fully developed, cannot provide enough oxygen, causing breathing difficulties. And this is one of the major problems that we are facing. Therefore, there are devices to assist your baby's breathing. There are many different types of these machines, ranging from mechanical ventilators when your baby cannot breathe by its own, to some nasal cannulas when your baby can breathe by its own and just needs some extra oxygen. Of course, it's the neonatologist who decides which type of breathing support is needed. For you, the important information is how to handle a given device, so you do not tear anything out, you do not peel off anything, etc. So never do anything on your own and remember that you can always ask the staff if you have any questions or doubts. Breath-helping machines cause the most concern among parents, but the good news is that in some cases it is possible to pick up the baby along with the machine and position it over the parent's chest so that both of them can enjoy the skin-to-skin contact benefits. In this case, of course, you need the consent of the doctor and the help of the medical staff when moving the baby. Next thing you can probably see is a small tube which goes to your baby's mouth or nose. This is a special tube that goes to your baby's esophagus. Through this tube, the baby is given food, the breast milk, formula or mix. This tube is called OG tube, orogastric tube, when it goes in your baby's mouth, or an NG tube, nasogastric tube, when it goes in your baby's nose. Why do we need to use them? Because a premature baby may not be able to eat by its own yet. And it's not just about suck reflex as most parents think, because suck reflex may occur around the 32nd week of pregnancy, but may not be fully developed until 36 weeks. But eating is a rather complicated activity for the baby, which requires a combination of sucking, swallowing and breathing. And for a premature baby, it is simply impossible to eat independently at some point. And that is why we are using gastric tubes. Of course, we try to switch to better feeding methods as the baby grows. We try with the bottle or directly to the breast. So learning to eat can be quite a long journey on the NICU. Another small device that you will definitely see is a pulse oximeter. This is a completely harmless device that measures oxygen saturation, usually together with the heart rate. It causes no pain and it works totally the same as with adults. Adults put the device on the finger, but of course baby is too small for that, so we put it on baby's hand or foot. The parameters shown by pulse ox are very important for the medical staff. Note that these parameters differ between adults and children, especially premature ones. For example, a premature baby will have much higher heart rate than an adult. So don't be scared of it, and if you have any questions or concerns, just ask the medical staff. Next thing you may see on your baby is an IV. This is an intravenous line, which can be placed in the hand, foot or scalp of the baby, where the veins are easily accessed. As the name implies, this is an access to the vein through which the baby is given medicines and fluids. There are different types of vascular access depending on current needs. The IVs are secured with appropriate plaster, so handle them carefully and try not to tear them off. Okay, so these are basic devices that you can find in the NICU, and I hope that now the appearance of the word is not so scary anymore. Here I will give you some medical articles about heart rate ranges in premature neonates and about optimal oxygen saturation in premature infants. If you want to take a look, I will also put it in the movie description. If you like the video, please give me a thumb up, feel free to subscribe, and thanks for watching. Bye! Thank you.